Some families upset tonight. They say a sacred place to remember their lost loved ones is being neglected. A recent Facebook post showing pictures of overgrown grave markers and headstones at a Lexington cemetery has many frustrated. Alexa Helwig went there to get answers, and that's our LEX 18 Big Story at 6.
Ada Mitchell says for the last 4 years, she's come to Cove Haven Cemetery to spend time with her mom.
Happy birthday, Mommy. I love you so much.
Mitchell says her mom, Helen, would have turned 75 years old today. She made the two-hour drive from Dayton, Ohio to Lexington, a trip she makes several times a year.
This is a sacred place. I sit on the ground here when I talk to my mom. I pray on the ground right here talking to my mom.
But today when she pulled into the gravesite, she tells me grass was over the top of her headstone, which broke her heart. She immediately got in touch with friends to come and cut around the grave.
But the blessing is, I got this done, but I can't do everybody's, you know? And their families shouldn't have to come out here to do it either.
A recent Facebook post sparked conversation with several others wondering why the upkeep has been slacking.
I've looked at other grave sites down there where water's overlapping them. You can't see the graves. I see grave sites where the tombstones been knocked down. There's wood where they cut trees at.
Unfortunately, the woman who ran the cemetery passed away 2 weeks ago and has been sick for a while. Two newly elected board members were at the grounds today, letting families know they're working to get back on a good maintenance schedule.
We understand her situation and we want to commend her for the effort that she was able to do. But there's a new board that has been formed to pick up where she left off and start to make things a little bit better.
They tell me starting Tuesday, professionals will be at the cemetery to begin the work, but they're also asking for help from the community. Covering the news in Lexington, Alexa Helwig, LEX 18 News.
Boone County officials investigate a